In this video, I want to show you how you can take photos from the inbuilt camera application of your mobile device without losing the quality of the image. To take photos from the camera, what most of us do is we take the photo through intent and we end up getting the thumbnail of the image. But in this video, I'll show you how you can get the actual image and not the thumbnail. I found a few videos on YouTube that talked about this topic, but the methods that they used in those videos are deprecated and they can be no longer of any use. So in this video, I'll show you how you can do this in 2019. So let's get started. Let's create the required layout. Replace the root element with relative layout. Remove this text view. Add a button. Set width and height to wrap content. Give this button an ID. I'm gonna call it a button. Set text to take photo. Now add an image view inside this layout. Set width and height to wrap content. Place this image view below the button. Give this image view an ID. Now open the manifests file and under the application tag, we will have to create a provider. For authorities, pass the package name. You can find the package name over here. In my case, it is com.example.youtubetutorial. So first type in the package name. And after the name of the package, put a dot and then type file provider. The name is going to be androidx.fileprovider. After this, set exported to true and then grant URI permissions to true. Create metadata inside this provider, where the name is going to be android.support_file_provider_paths. And inside the metadata, we will need resources too. And here we are gonna create an XML file called file paths. Press Alt Enter while the cursor is on the red text and create an XML resource file and make sure the directory name here is XML. Press OK. Remove this preferences and add paths. Inside path, add a tag of external path. There are three: external files path, cache path, and path. We are gonna choose path. Name of this path is going to be my images. It could be anything, it doesn't matter. And then the path is going to be android/data/your package name. Here it is com.example.youtubetutorial. After this, put a slash and then files. And after files, you have to type the name of the folder where you are going to store the images. Here, I'm gonna just store it in pictures. Okay, after your file paths.xml file looks something like this. And this should be your package name and not mine. So once this is done, go to the mainActivity.java class. And inside the onCreate, find the button by its ID. Set the button on ClickListener. Now what we are going to do is first we will create a file and we will store the image taken from the camera in that file through intent. Before we create the file, we will have to create a file name. Create a string and call this string file name. To keep it simple, I'm just gonna call this photo. But remember, you will have to make the file name unique if you don't want it to get overwritten. Now create an object of file class and call this variable storage directory. And using the function get external files directory, we will get the file for the environment.directory_pictures. Once we have this, we will create one more file and we will call this file image file. We are going to store our photo inside this file and using the static function file.createTempFile, we are going to create the file where the first parameter is going to be the name of the file, which is file name. And the second parameter is going to be the extension of the file. Here I'm gonna use .jpg. And the last parameter is going to be the directory where we want to save this file. Pass storage directory variable here. This create temp file function throws IO exception. So press Alt Enter and surround it with try catch. Now create a global variable of type string. Call this current photo path. This current photo path variable is going to store the path of the image. So set current photo path equals image file dot get absolute path. We will need this current photo path to get the bitmap. And after this, create an intent. This intent will be of type media store dot action image capture. And then call intent dot put extra media store dot extra output. Here we will have to pass the URI of the file where we want to save the image. And to get the URI, what you need to do is you need to call file provider dot get URI for file. This function returns the URI for a file, of course, where the first parameter is the context. Here it's going to be main activity dot this. And second parameter is authority, which is going to be same as what we have in the manifest file. So copy this authorities and paste that authority in the get URI for file method as a string. The last parameter is the file for which we want the URI. So here it is image file. And we are going to store the value returned by this get URI for file function in an object of type URI. We are going to call it image URI. Once you have the image URI, pass it as the second parameter to the put extra method. After this, we can just call start activity for result to start our intent. Pass the intent as the first parameter. Second parameter is the request code. I'm going to pass 1. Once you are done with this, implement the method onActivityResult. And inside this method, check for the condition if request code is 1 and result code is okay. If everything went fine, then we will create a variable named bitmap. And using the bitmap factory.decode file function, we are gonna get the image stored at the file current photo path. After you have the bitmap, create an object of image view and refer this to the image that we have in the layout file. Lastly, set the bitmap of this image view to the bitmap that we just decoded from the file. Before we can run and test this, we have to make a change in the manifest file. So open it. We cannot export this provider, so we have to set it to false. Because if we export the provider, then the application would crash. Okay, so now everything is done. Let's run and test this application. The application is running. Click on the take photo button. The camera will open. And through this camera application, take a photo. Once you have taken the photo, click on the blue button. And you can see the image gets added and the quality of the image is not lost.